Well, joining us now is Ken Cuccinelli, chairman of the Election Transparency Initiative and former Virginia Attorney General. Ken, welcome back. Great to see you. As we just heard, all eyes are on West Virginia Democrat Joe Manchin right now. What do you think of his proposed changes to the voting rights bill, and how do you think this will all play out?
Federal takeover. It is literally intended to displace states and have a one-size-fits-all federal approach to elections. And so many of the troublesome practices that we saw in various places in 2020, they're seeking to codify, like ballot harvesting, like not allowing confirmation of who is in front of the election official to vote, same-day registration, so many problems where they are building in an easy system to cheat where it's hard to prove. We want it easy to vote and hard to cheat. They appear to want it to be easy to cheat and hard to prove. But I do expect Senator Manchin, with his relatively small number of concessions that he got, to agree to the bill, which will make it 50-50, though procedurally, I'm not sure they'll even get to the bill today because it will be filibustered, as you heard from Senator McConnell, because of has been a product of the radical left for a number of years. This didn't just happen this year. Chuck Schumer is trying to suggest that it's just a response to reform efforts in the states, but that is not true, patently untrue. This has been around for a number of years.
Well, just yesterday, Monmouth University released a poll that found 80% of people surveyed are in favor of showing some form of identification in order to vote. When it came to voting by mail, 50% of those surveyed said they supported making it easier. Let's talk a little bit more about these results, and how do you think that plays into the debate?
Well, you know, because, for instance, I've been trying to debate someone on the left on the subject, and they won't do it because they have a hard time with the facts, and you just laid some out. The results in a Monmouth poll with 80% support for voter ID are not unique. They have been that way for months and months and months. And when you divorce the elements of citizen bickering over a very commonsensical approach, and there's actually a lot of unity among the American people. Biden voters themselves, black voters, Hispanic voters as well, all overwhelmingly support voter ID, just to use the simplest example. It's when it gets into the political arena that there's so many problems. And as you heard Senator McConnell and others just rattle off example after example of the bad provisions of this bill that really do make it ridiculously easy to cheat. And you have to ask yourself, why would someone put in a bill? They eat, and hard to draw any other conclusion at this point. And that's not something that we can let go by quietly and without a fight. We need to preserve our elections and improve them, not undermine them.
Well, switching gears, we have about a minute left or so. Tomorrow, President Biden is expected to address the spike in crime and gun violence that many cities across the U.S. have been experiencing, and will also present his administration's plan to combat it. What are you hoping to hear from him, and what do you think needs to be done?
Criminals. And we'll know this administration is serious when they start deporting criminal aliens, people they have in their custody who've committed violent crimes, who are here illegally, who they can easily remove from the country. When they start doing that, we'll know they're serious about fighting crime. They need to get back in the business of supporting law enforcement instead of undermining law enforcement. You cannot undermine law enforcement and expect crime to go down. There are some on the left actually blaming the police for the spike in crime, which is ludicrous, as police of the and the lack of support they're getting all over the country.
Well, Ken, thank you so much for your time today. We really appreciate it. Ken Cuccinelli, chairman of the Election Transparency Initiative and former Virginia Attorney General. Thank you again.
Good to be with you.